गुड इवनिंग टू वन एंड ऑल, वेलकम बैक आवर फेवरेट वीडियो चैनल श्री गणित विज्ञान सर्वस्वम। दिस इज बी रमेश कुमार, जेएल इन मैथमेटिक्स। नाउ वी डिस्कस जेएम एंड 2020 चैप्टर वाइज सॉल्यूशंस। इन प्रीवियस वीडियोस मोर टॉपिक्स आर डिस्कस्ड हियर। नाउ दिस टाइम वी डिस्कस वन ऑफ द चैप्टर सर्कल्स। From this chapter, there are four questions came from this topic in January 2020 session. Now we discuss the solutions of that questions. Now the first problem is, let the tangents drawn from the origin to the circle x square plus y square minus 8x minus 4y plus 16 equals 0 touch it at the points A and B. Then the value of AB whole square equals 2. Here in this problem, the two tangents drawn from the origin. Now we take one xy plane. This is origin O 0 0. And we take one circle. Now we draw two tangents from this origin. These tangents touch at the two points A and B respectively. Now here we join AB and this is center. Now AB forms one chord of contact to this circle. Now find this length of AB. Direct using the formula. The formula is length of the chord of contact. AB equals to 2R into square root S11 by square root of S11 plus R square. Now we are find radius and length of the tangent. Here square root S11 equals to square root of here X1Y1 is origin 0 0. Now square root S11 means 0 square, 0 plus 0 minus 0 minus 0 plus 16. Total value is root 16, that is 4. This is length of the tangent. Similarly, we find radius also. Here center C equals to 4 comma 2 and radius R equals to square root of 4 square plus 2 square minus 16. Here 16, 4 square cancel and 2 square means 4, square root 4 means 2. Now radius is 2. Now these values substitute in this formula. The length AB equals to 2 into R value is 2 into square root S11 means 4 by square root of S11. S11 means 4 square. That is 16 plus R square, 2 square. So 4 4 is 16 by root 20. That means 16 by 2 root 5. This is 8 by root 5. Now therefore AB square equals to 8 by root 5 whole square. That equals to 64 by 5. Now which is in the option 2. This is the solution for this problem. Now the second one is, if your line y equal to mx plus c is tangent to the circle x minus 3 whole square plus y square equals to 1 and it is perpendicular to a line L1 where L1 is tangent to the circle x square plus y square equal to 1 at the point 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, then which of the option is correct? Here to find relation in C. So, in this problem, given the line y equal to mx plus c is tangent to the circle x minus 3 whole square plus y square equals to 1 and this line is perpendicular to L1. Now, first of all, we find the line L1. Now this L1 is tangent to this circle at the point 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. So this is point of contact. So first we find the line L1, the tangent equation to this circle at this point. Now the solution is, here L1 means S1 equal to 0, which implies XX1 plus YY1 minus 1 equal 0 at 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. Now which implies 1 by root 2x plus 1 by root 2y minus 1 equal 0. Now that is x plus y minus root 2 equal 0. Now which is L1. Here to find slope. Now we say M1 equals to minus a by b, that is minus 1 by 1 equals to minus 1. Now n, in the given first condition, y equal to mx plus c is tangent to that circle. Now here given tangent line, let it be some L, is y equals to mx plus c. Since this is perpendicular to the line L1. Since L is perpendicular to L1. Now which implies the product of slopes equals to minus 1. Now here the product of slopes. The slope of L is M. And the slope of L1 is minus 1. Equals to minus 1, which implies m equals to 1. Now we observe that the slope of the first tangent line L is 1, therefore equation of L equals to y equals to 1 into x plus c, which implies x minus y plus c, which equals to 0. Now this is tangent to the circle x minus 3 whole square plus y square equals to 1. Since L is tangent to circle x minus 3 whole square plus y square equals to 1, then the perpendicular distance from the center to this circle equals to radius. Perpendicular distance from C 3 comma 0 to L equals to radius. Now to find perpendicular distance to this line x minus y plus c equals 0, which implies, so here the x value is 3 minus 0 plus c by square root of 1 square plus minus 1 whole square equals radius equals to 1. Now which implies 3 plus c by root 2 modulus equals to 1. Now squaring on both sides, 3 plus c whole square equals to 2. Now this is 9 plus c square plus 6c equals to 2. Now we can simplify 6 square, c square plus 6c, 9 minus 2 plus 7 equal to 0. Now this is the solution, which is in the option 4. Now the third one is, a circle touches the y-axis at the point 0, 4 and passing through the point 2, 0. Which of the following lines is not a tangent to the circle? Now here, find in the given four options, which of the line is not a tangent. Now first of all, we find the equation of circle. Here from the circle, using the center and radius, and here we check perpendicular distance equals to radius to the given options. Now, which of the option is not a tangent? So here first we observe that the circle touches the y-axis and also given 1.04. Here we observe
in this point x coordinate is 0. That means 0, 4 is always lie on y axis. And also that circle passing through the point 2, 0. Now here we observe, in this point y coordinate is 0. That means this point is always lie on x axis. Now here we take xy plane and one circle. First we draw one circle and touches y axis and passing through the point 2, 0. That means here we observe that this circle passing through this point, that means we take x axis. In this x axis 2, 0 is one of the point. That means this x axis cuts the circle at two points. Let it be the two points B, A and B. And we take, this is center C. And also touches y axis at the point 0, 4. This is C. Some this is some D. Here we observe that this is origin 0, 0. This point is exterior to the circle. And this is x axis. We observe that this x axis passing through the point O and cuts at two points A and B to the circle. Now here the product OA into OB is always said to be power of the point to the circle. So here power of the point equals to OA into OB. And also we observe this point lie outside the circle and also y axis touches the circle. Now here we observe that this distance, so OD, is called length of the tangent. That means the square of the length of the tangent is always called power of the point. Now here the square of the length of the tangent, that means this is denoted by OD square, that is S11 equals to OA into OB. Here the distance from the origin to the point is 4 units. So this is 4 square equals to OA, means distance from the origin to the point A, that is 2 units, into OB. Now to find OB, that equals to 16 by 2 equals to 8. So here to find the length of the chord, here the secant line cuts the circle at two points. Here AB forms one chord. AB forms one chord. Now here to find AB. Here to find AB. That means now subtract from OA, subtract from OB to OA. That is OB minus OA. Here OB means 8 units, OA means 2 units, that is 6 units. Now the length of the chord is 6. Now here we draw one perpendicular line from the center to the chord. This perpendicular line bisects the chord. Bisects the chord. Now this line intersects this chord some point, at some point, some cap lem. Here AM equals to MB equals to 6 by 2, that equals 3 units, because of CM is always perpendicular to AB. This perpendicular line is this line is always perpendicular to AB. Therefore here this line bisects the chord. And we observe that join center C to D. Let it be radius is R. Radius be some R. Now here we observe that this distance, so this distance is parallel to y axis, so this is also 4 units. And we observe that join AC. Here we form one right angle triangle from triangle CAM using Pythagoras formula. this is 3 units, this is 4 units. CA equals to radius equals to square root of 3 square plus 4 square. That means this is 5. Now here the radius of the circle is 5 units. And also we have find OM. OM is always parallel to DC. That is also OM is equals to also CD or DC. That means the distance from the origin to M, OM equals to, here we write OA plus AM. OM is 2 and AM is 3. That is 5. Now here this is parallel to CD and this is always equals to CD. So total value is 5. So therefore center of the circle equals to, here the x coordinate is 5 and y coordinate is always equals to 4. Now center of the circle is 5, 4 and radius of the circle is 5. Now here verify the perpendicular distance equals to radius, because of already given the lines are given in the options to verify which option is not a tangent. That means in this one perpendicular distance is not equals to radius, then that line is not a tangent. Now we take first option using verification method. First option, the line is 4x minus 3y plus 17 equals 0. Here the condition is perpendicular distance equals to radius. Now first we'll find perpendicular distance from the center 5, 4. Now 4 into 5 minus 3 into 4 plus 17 by square root of 4 square plus minus 3 square. So this is 16 plus 9 equals to, here this is 20 minus 12 plus 17. So 37 minus 12, this is 5. So that is 25 by 5. So 5, 5 is here. So which is equals to R. Now therefore option 1 is tangent. Tangent line. Now using same process, the second option is, the line is 3x plus 4y minus 6 equals 0. Now we check perpendicular distance. 3 into the center is 5. 3 into 5 plus 4 into 4 minus 6 by this is 5. So here 15 plus 16, 31 minus 6, 25 by 5. That is also 5, which is always equals to radius. So option 2 also tangent line. And we take the third option, 4x plus 3y minus 8 equals 0. Here the perpendicular distance, 4 into 5 plus 3 into 4 minus 8 by 5. Here 20 plus 12, 32. 32 minus 8, 24 by 5, which is not equals to 5. That is first R. Therefore, option 2, option 3 is not a tangent. And we check fourth option also. Here in the fourth option the line is 3x minus 4y minus 24 equals 0. Now we check perpendicular distance. Here 3 into 5 minus 4 into 4 minus 24 by 5. So 15 minus 16 minus 1 minus 24 minus 25 modulus minus 25 by 5. So which is also 5, that equals to R. Therefore here also fourth option is also tangent line. Therefore, which is tangent. Here, from four options, third option is not a tangent line. Now, our solution is third option. This is the solution for this problem. Now, the fourth one is, if the curves x square minus 6x plus y square plus 8 equal to 0 and x square minus 8y plus y square plus 16 minus k equal to 0. Here k is always greater than 0. Touch each other. Now here these are two circles. We observe that x square plus y square minus 6x plus 8 equal 0 and x square plus y square minus 8y plus 16 minus k equal 0. Now we observe that these curves are circles. Now these circles touch each other at a point, either internally or externally. Here we observe either internally or externally. Then the largest value of k. Here find the value of k, which is the maximum value. So first of all, given curves are x square minus 6x plus y square plus 8 equal 0. Now this curve, let it be some s, and s dash equals to x square minus 8y plus y square plus 16 minus k equal 0. Here k is always greater than 0. Now to find center and radius of both curves or circles, here c1 equals to 3 comma 0 and r1 equals to square root of 9 plus 0 minus 8. This is 1. And here c2 equals to x coordinate 0 and y coordinate minus 8 means 4, and r2 equals to square root of 0 square, that means 0 plus 4 square, 16 minus of 16 minus k, that equals to, here 16 cancel, square root of k. This is the radius of second circle. Now here we observe these circles are touch each other at a point, either internal or external. So here the circles or curves touch each other, either internal or either external or internal at one point. Now the condition is, since given curves are touch each other at a point, internal or external, then the condition distance between center C1, C2 is always equals to modulus of R1 plus or minus R2. Here we take either internal or external. For example, these circles touches external, that means distance between centers equals to sum of the radius, that means r1 plus r2. Suppose the circles touches internally, then distance between the centers is always equals to modulus of r1 minus r2. Now here maybe the circles touches either internally or externally. Now the condition is c1 c2 equals to modulus of r1 plus r minus r2. Now substitute the values. Here c1 c2 means distance between centers, that is here the two centers are 3 0 and 0 4, so 3 minus 0 square, that is 9, plus 0 minus 4 square, that is 16, so this is 5, that equals to modulus of r1 means this is 1 plus or minus r2 means root k. Now which implies we take plus value, phi equals to 1 plus root k, or phi equals to minus of 1 minus root k, which implies root k equals to 4, k equals to 16, or in this one, here phi equals to minus 1 plus root k, which implies root k equals to 5 plus 1, 6, that means k equals to 36. We observe that from these values, the largest value or maximum value is 36. So the largest value of k is 36. So which is always positive. Now, which is integer equation? This is the solution for this problem. So these are the solutions of these problems. Now prepare and practice more problems from this topic. So wish you all the best. Thank you.